You can't expect all of that to just evaporate because I love you.
I love you. Why shouldn't that be something good? This is what matters. And I love you. I love you too.
Never have I ever stage kissed / film kissed someone and then actually really enjoyed it.
Wait a minute.
Damn you! Oh, I see how it is.
You weren't gonna put that down.
I was waiting to see what your reaction was.
I got confused.
I didn't even understand.
No. Wait, redo that.
No. Where did you
no
say?
No redoosies. No, I got confused. I was like, what do you mean you didn't enjoy it? I got very sad.
I can see you in like French braids and a bonnet, maybe.
Hmm. Would you like that?
Well, sorry, so my post-traumatic revelation was inconveniently timed for you.
Your post-traumatic, oh, you mean how you're a realist now?
Yeah.
A realist? Really?
Well, it's better than being a—
You're just lying to yourself about that. A what?
Smug.
Hypocritical.
Superior.
Delusional.
Condescending.
Tightly wound.
Narcissistic.
Oh, prissy.
Uncaring.
Nerdy.
Nihilistic.
Little journalist.
Little
you wish
undead.
You were.
I fell in love.
So oh, what's that? Oh, I'm just gonna go for a little swim in your belly button. Oh,
what's happening? I don't think we can use any of that.
Oh.
Is that your belly button? I put my finger in your belly button before, so I know. Never the pinky, though. It was the first time
there
for everything.
Thank you. And especially to my beautiful co-star, who is the real backbone of the little web series That Could. You inspire me to work harder every day, Elise, so thank you so much for being my on-screen love interest. Thank you. And maybe my real-life one sometimes.
I chose to bring Elise as my date because there's no one else I would have wanted to be there. I mean, she deserves to be there just as much as anybody else. I knew that she had never been to a Canadian Screen Awards show before, and I knew that she would get to be in the same room as some of her heroes, and I just think that she works so incredibly hard on set and is such a wonderful actor and person, and I know that I wouldn't be Carmilla if it wasn't for our chemistry, so I do owe a lot of this to her as well, and she was really lovely and supportive. I think it's really cool when women can lift each other up in this difficult industry.
But I think that Carmilla and Laura are more similar than people
think they are. Yeah.
Whoa.
You are great. Certainly more than friends. You have started completing each other's sentences.
Yeah.
Or at least surprised to see you making another video instead of snuggling up with your nice, warm...
Whoa there, lady killer.
Let's have a romantic moment.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, yours is so much more teeny.
Let's have a romantic moment.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, yours is so much more teeny.
Let's have a romantic moment.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, yours is so much more teeny.
Let's have a romantic moment.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, yours is so much more teeny.
Let's have a romantic moment.
Oh, that's nice.
Oh yeah, yours is so much more teeny.
I don't know, we just did it. And I thought to myself, if I get cast, that's my Laura. Aww. Yeah.
Yo, yours is nice.
Only the best for my Laura.
As I have to say, for lack of a better word, there is just this magic when I work with her. You know, from the second I auditioned, I knew that if I got the role of Carmilla, that she would be my Laura.
Yeah.
I think there's something about an innate chemistry that you have with a person that is sometimes not... There's no logical answer for it. I think it was very much like even when I auditioned with Elise in the callback, it was like something instantly connected, and there was something I knew in that moment. I was like, if I get cast, like that's definitely my Laura. And I always just sort of knew that.
Oh my god, Laura, you dork.
Theoretically, if we wanted to have a little fun right now.
Are you pulling on her hair? What's going on?
Good.
Definitely. Oh my god. This is...
The whole reason we can't have fun. Ever we like.
Great. Excellent. Also,
and here we go.
Someone's supposed to have an entrance right now.
Yeah,
but they missed.
I missed it. Because I...
I don't think anyone's going to
know
what
you're planning is your entrance.
I do have a big girl song. You're just here.
Love and pain? Tell me you didn't just
say that. I don't think it was meant. No, I think it was. Like, I don't think we were even supposed to
get that.
I wasn't.
You were supposed to.
I wasn't also supposed to.
Into frame and it's like already sexy. So.
Oh, you don't.
Would have been good. Oh, do I have just stuff? I'm a mess. I'm a hot mess.
Nah. Just hot.
Just kidding. I'm composed.
Finally being free. To do anything, go wherever we want. Oh, like Paris. We could go to Paris and get a crappy apartment and read Simone de Beauvoir and eat chocolate croissants. And by we, I mean you.
I always wanted to go to Paris or London or just the world. I just wanted to travel.
Paris, je t'aime.
What should we do? Should we go to the Louvre? Go see the Oracle at the Moulin Rouge?
No.
Stuff ourselves with pain de chocolat.
Traveling wears a girl out. Uh-huh. All I'm thinking about is going to bed. And not getting out for a week. Let's go kiss like the French do.
I love skinny dipping is one of my favorite things ever, especially when it's under the moonlight and you're naked.
Wait, that's what skinny dipping is!
There's
going to
be a whole bunch of new
fan fiction.
I
really love skinny dipping when you're naked.
There's going to be a whole bunch of new fan fiction.
Yeah, right.
I do love skinny dipping in the dark when it is pitch black and you are in a lake. And all you can see is the stars, and like there's no difference between the sky and the water.
Sounds like my nightmare.
That is like a beautiful, beautiful thing.
Awful. I will be sitting on the dock just being like, please don't die.
You'll be like writing, and yeah. I'll just be like.
Have you ever skinny dipped?
God, no.
You don't like what? Water? And
I don't
like being
like
naked.
Water.
So
and you also don't like murky water, fish in water.
And like, no, like nighttime would never do it.
I completely agree.
Oh, it's my favorite.
What if fish get in your vagina?
Exactly.
Away, all I could think was that you needed to get away from me.
God.
You just needed to get out.
Oh my God.
From all that smoke. So you wouldn't do it. You stayed there. In the passenger seat, just wailing away, rolling down the window, screaming. The paramedics came and they said that that you probably saved my life. And even then, you were willing to risk your life for someone else.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, you guys.
And that has terrified me for a long time.
I don't know what you want me to say, Carm. I wish I could say that it doesn't matter, but it does.
Do you miss me?
Like someone cut a hole in me.
We may have not been friends if we had not done this show together, because we probably would have been like, you know, she would have been like, oh, that's just a little city kid. And I would have been like, that's just a small town girl. Whatever, you know, I don't know. Like, you know, we would have
been like,
punch her
down
the city. Yeah, we're like, punch her down the city now. Meaningful and unlikely animal friendship. We're a chicken and a monkey.
Yeah.
Chicken and a monkey?
Yeah.
I
don't know. She always calls me chicken and I always call her monkey. It's like a weird thing. Anyway.
The campus needs our help. I can't just walk away again. That wouldn't be me. And maybe deep down, that's kind of what you like about me, isn't it?
You're killing me, Hollis.
Yeah, but you were already dead. Oh, look! I think the passageway back to the old base camp is opening up! Do you remember this hallway leading through a forest? Oh, look! That fox has 9 tails!
Still killing me, Hollis.
No, we are not dating. But we've heard each other fart, so we're basically girlfriends. But let's be honest, Elise. We'd make a pretty cute couple.
Look at us. Making plans, strategizing, comrades working shoulder to shoulder with no desperate kissing or lusty sexual undertones. No awkwardness, just good old-fashioned platonic buddies.
Mm.
I'm not saying that there haven't been slips.
Okay.
Office furniture related slips. But look at us now. We're having a perfectly civil conversation. Mm-hmm. Oh, crap. That is turning out to be habit forming.
You're Nat Alton. I'm Nat Alton. We seem to be enjoying each other.
Well, there was definite enjoyment.
So I'm thinking that maybe we could just, you know, continue that enjoyment. You know, as long as we don't get all doomed and star-crossed about it, we'll be fine. We'll keep it casual.
Light.
Very light.
It is so beautiful. The way you try. What?
To hell with light and casual.
I need to go shopping. What are you doing today?
Nothing. And no, I will not go shopping.
Oh, yes, you are. Oh.
Immature. And there she goes.
Okay, so there's obviously a lot of clips of you and Natasha breaking things on set. I was wondering, how busy are you in real life? Is it that bad?
Yeah, they actually reinforced this chair for me. They knew I was coming, so they
made of steel.
Yes, made of steel. It's cemented, it's drilled into the stage. Yeah, definitely. What else to say? But she breaks the most hearts.
We'll take anything you've painted. Money's no object.
Really? Since when?
Elise, I make six figures drinking blood on the net.
Yeah, I know you do. I wish you didn't.
Why? It's not cheating.
Maybe not to you, it isn't.
You know what? I'm just gonna leave you.
You briefly worked with Natasha Nikovanis and Elise Bauman in one scene.
Yes, I did. Yes. I remember these girls.
I was just wondering, what was it like working with them and like...
The two of them have such great chemistry and rapport.
They really do.
I was like just watching the two of them chat between them. I was like, this is amazing. I could sell tickets to this, which then I subsequently discovered they pretty much do. Because I wasn't really aware of who they were until they came in and they told me. I was just sort of like, this is amazing.
It was like fandoms colliding.
Yeah, it was, because I'm not on social media, so I don't really know. But I was just like, this, I could just get popcorn and hey. They were sweet girls, sweet, sweet, and very good. And I, you know, subsequently discovered it was a big deal to be working with them, and I should have known
massive,
that at the time.
Massive. There's someone else joining the cast this year, Dominique Provost-Chalky from White.
I guess I got to work with her the most, and she was such a treat to work with, and such a pleasure to work with, and such a giving, talented actor, and we really hit it off right away. We like totally bonded because we're like a few days apart, you know. We learned that we're both like Aries ladies. She was just awesome, and I was so excited to work with her. I've wanted to work with her for a long time now, and she was just really fun to play with, and I loved the amount of prep she did as well. Like just even looking at her script and how many notes she had written in it, and I love that she took so much care because she knows how important this is to us and to you, and so. Yeah, I wish she could be here, but she's brilliant, and I'm really excited for you all to see her in it as Elves of Love.
Settle. I was hearing a little bit of
chit-chat
on the porch, please.
Just to make things complicated.
I have Laura goggles on.
No, let's not make things complicated.
Why would I do that? Maybe. We want it dirty,
use your the fingerprints on it?
Yeah, yeah, it's good. This is it. It's real.
Right.
Here we go. And action.